criminals beware.
We're installing them tomorrow.
Sweet release.
Is that Copperhead?
Apparently.
What?
It's time to strike. Suffering! Have some convicts. Surprise! Prison cell.
Yeah, I figured you'd say something like that. Anyway, the prison's safe now. Another criminal thwarted, thanks to Batman and the Blue. Hey, wait up!
Ready to deliver some justice.
I will serve dutifully.
It's totally my fault! Ah, why am I such...
Our plan is to infiltrate...
Whoa! What is...
With any luck, Grodd hasn't reached the complex yet. And even if he has, it'll still take him some time to get inside.
Man, that Protobot guy is huge. I bet he could just sit on Grodd. Splat! No more monkey troubles.
Jaime, stay focused.
Right. Focused. I can do that. Why, do I seem unfocused to you? Hey, do you think they have coconuts on this island?
Gorillas, up ahead.
So what's the deal with Protobot?
I just told you.
Oh, I mean, he doesn't talk like your typical robot.
Proto was the first in a series of defensive robots I created. In some ways, he's less advanced than the later models. But he also ended up being a great friend.
I get you. You know, I wanted a robot for a best friend, too. Of course, I was 7 at the time. You sure you don't want to bring him along? I mean, maybe we could be his backup.
Right now, the name of the game is stealth. That's one area Proto doesn't excel at.
I can imagine.
The streets are safe once again. Keep your eyes peeled and your fists ready.
I will serve dutifully.
send in the robot cavalry. Blue Beetles represent. Go, Blue!
Can you try not to embarrass us for 5 minutes?
Hey, wait, are those things going to attack us next?
We've been here before, remember, Jaime?
That's right. These robots were built by Ted Kord, the original Blue Beetle.
Your predecessor. So let them do their thing, and we'll do ours.
Their thing looks a lot cooler. You're pretty cool too, Scarab. It must be annoying hopping between those rocks, Batman. You sure you don't want me to fly us the rest of the way there? I bet I could get us there in 5 minutes flat. Well, maybe 10. Actually, which way are we headed again?
I'll stick with the rocks, thanks.
When we get there, knock on the front door, check under the mat for a key.
Like I said, I know a few secret entrances into the compound. Rod shouldn't have any idea about them, and it'll take him a while to get in through the front gate.
Right, right. I don't suppose we passed one of these secret doorways already? Like a shortcut so we can get off these rocks?
I said secret entrance, Jaime, not secret tunnel.
Gotcha. Harm in asking, right? Since you don't want my help, would you mind if I rode on your back? My wings are getting a little tired with all this flying over every obstacle.
Was that a joke?
Sort of.
Don't quit your day job.
Hey. I guess you think I'm a pretty bad superhero for letting Grodd know about this place.
You're not a bad hero, but you could learn to keep quiet once in a while.
Right. Good advice. Good advice. I'm actually really good at staying quiet. Not a lot of people know that about me. There was this one time, a couple years ago, maybe like 6 or 8 months ago, I didn't talk for like a whole hour, like an entire hour. It's just crazy, right?
I may.
What? Oh, yeah. Oh, sorry. Right. Sorry. You were right.
The streets are safe once again. It's a perfect night for saving the city.
I will serve dutifully.
So how do we know if Grodd's gotten inside yet?
Keep an eye out for signs.
You mean like banana peels? Tree branches? Issues of Popular Gorilla Monthly?
More like piles of wreckage and debris. Grodd and his gorillas aren't very subtle.
Check. We should keep a lookout for banana peels too, though.
Be my guest.
See? Banana peel! Called it! Ape alert! I found some wreckage. You were right. Guess they beat us inside.
It certainly appears so.
We should be able to bust right through this. We could tidy up later.
More wreckage.
I got this one, Batman. Step aside and watch these pistons do their thing. Ready, Scarab?
The wreckage is too thick. All you'll do is let everyone know where we are. Let's find another way.
Are you sure? Because I think I can...
Come on.
What if I'm really quiet?
Just one piston?
I've seen your pistons. They're not quiet.
Why is Grodd so obsessed with technology anyway?
He's a criminal mastermind who rules his city based on the idea that he's the smartest one in it. Technology equals intelligence in his eyes. That, and he likes shiny things.
So Grodd's some kind of super genius, right?
The talking didn't give it away.
What about the rest of the apes? Are they super intelligent too? I mean, I've seen them use guns, but I've also seen them scratch their butts for 10 minutes.
I wouldn't say genius, but all gorillas from Gorilla City possess an above-average level of intelligence.
Gorilla City? That's where they live? Elevator. Oh, nice. How does that thing work, anyway? You know what? Maybe you should keep doing it.
Good idea.
Looks like we need to... Good hero has one. You've got the Batcave somewhere, right?
Yes.
Well, you think the old Blue Beetle would mind if I set up shop here? Since we...
Arkham's going to be busy tonight. Get ready to deliver some justice.
I will serve dutifully.
It looks like they've breached hallways all over the complex. We need to get to the control room. It's what Grodd will be searching for.
There's a control room? Why wasn't I told this?
If we can get there before him, we can turn on the rest of the complex's security measures and put everything in a lockdown state. That should drive Grodd and his soldiers
out of the complex. Are you kidding me?
What happens if he gets there before us?
Don't ask.
Something? Hero question.
Sure.
How do you keep yourself from getting a wedgie in your costume? And this thing's always riding up on me, and it's a little too snug in, you know, those delicate places. You know what I mean? I'm just used to wearing baggy clothes at school.
My outfit is made out of armor plating and synthetic fibers, not a bug on my back. A bug that can hear everything you're saying, I might remind you.
Oh, right. Sorry, buddy. No offense.
Watch out for the electrified floor.
Where?
The one you're about to walk onto.
Oh, right. Thanks for the heads up. I'll just not go down there then.
Good plan.
So before, when you said it would be a...
to call Blackgate. It's going to be a full house tonight. Criminals, beware.
Pretty tough when he...
Keep your eyes peeled and your fists ready.
I will serve dutifully.
I think Red Tornado might have the fastest dialogue. I haven't checked like literally everything else except for Red Tornado. But hopefully it does.
Maybe we should go back to the control room.
Grodd's too smart for that. By now, he's broken into the security wall or smashed the control room to pieces. Either way, being there won't help us gain control of the complex.
So what do we do?
For now, let's stay out of sight from Grodd's gorillas. Set up the system to defend against us and protect him and his gorillas.
Guess we lost our backup, huh?
Let's try to avoid detection. We need to travel where Grodd can't monitor us. Service tunnels, wiring shafts,
bathrooms. What? It's illegal to have cameras in there.
Really? Super intelligent? That one's eating a jar of mustard.
I may.
Right. Sorry.
I'm accessing the layout.
Locked in.
The streets are safe once again.
the perfect night for saving the city.
I will serve beautifully.
Oh, so 30 is possible. That's cool, basically. We can definitely save 36 seconds throughout this entire run.
All these complexes are built like a video game. Think about it. I mean, we're walking down a hallway. Oh, there's a door. But you gotta hit those three switches to open it. Dead end. Guess we have to backtrack. Oh, look, a new passage opened up. Now we just...
Jaime.
Yeah.
This is not a video game. Now, please, try to stay focused and keep the chatter to a minimum.
Focused. Minimum chatter. Press the B button. Got it. If Grodd finds the central core before we do, what's plan B?
Finding the central core is plan B.
So what if we can't-
Don't think like that, Jaime. A hero has to stay optimistic. You can't just hope for the best outcome. You have to believe you can actually accomplish it.
I could be optimistic. The next time I see Grodd, I'm gonna drop a robot on him. See? Totally optimistic.
Good. Arkham's going to be busy tonight. Get ready to deliver some justice.
I will serve dutifully.
The central core should be a few hundred meters ahead. We'll have to get past these electrical fields to reach it. And it will probably be well guarded.
You know, we could have just called Robobot in here to get it for us.
Protobot.
Yeah, him.
Robobot. Where the fuck are we supposed
to go? I bet it's like cheese puffs to them. All we get is a charred butt.
Quit complaining, hero.
Where are the platforms? Okay, that works.
So old. Why does everything look so advanced? I've been wondering that since the last time I came here.
The original Blue Beetle was way ahead of his time. He dreamt up
really?
That no one else would come up with for decades. Several of my gadgets are based on his designs.
Cool.
Of course, his greatest contributions to the world were the crimes he helped prevent. There are hundreds of people out there today living better lives because of Ted.
Pretty big shoes to fill.
Definitely.
How would you, say I'm doing so far?
Ask me after we stop Grodd.
Right. The mission. Got it.
God damn it. What? They can wait. That sucks.
Oh, come!
Another area made safe from crime. Get ready to deliver some justice.
I will serve dutifully.
Grab on, we can't let Grunt.
This is like surfing. Oh, I can get into this.
Don't let him get away. That device will allow Grunt to control any electrical device in the world, not just the ones on this island.
I wasn't planning on it. Oh, you have to admit, though, this totally seems like a level in some video game. It doesn't seem like we're gaining on him.
We are. Just try to keep balanced and take out any gorillas that come your way.
Take them out? I hardly know them. No, yeah, I'll take care of them. We should sell these things to kids. Oh, this is fun. This is way better than skateboarding or surfing. Plus, it shoots lasers. No, seriously, I bet we make like $1 million each. Don't you want to be rich? I need an archenemy. Every good hero has an archenemy that compliments him. What about Grodd? Does he have an archenemy?
Typically, the Flash takes care of Grodd.
Flash? How does that make sense? Monkey versus Speed? A good archvillain should be like an evil opposite version of the hero. Like Lex Luthor and Superman. Brains versus Brawn. Or you and the Joker. I mean, he is so funny and you're,
I'm what?
You're totally awesome. I swear we've passed that rock before. And that one. And that one. And that one. You think Grodd would ever hire human thugs? Or is he, like, stuck giving the work to apes? They don't seem very good. They don't even wear pants.
Well, generally, Grodd hates all humans.
He's probably jealous that we're potty trained. What's the deal with Grodd's helmet?
It boosts his mind control abilities.
What? I didn't know he could read minds.
Relax. I've got an electronic blocker in my ear, and your scarab blocks you. Unless Grodd has been using his mind control helmet to make you chatter about random nonsense this whole mission.
Nope, that's pretty much all me. Here's that rock again. I feel like we've been chasing him for ages.
It's been about 5 minutes.
Yeah, and in superhero time, that's like days. Surprised that thing can support him. I'm guessing Grodd doesn't do cardio. See? See? Right there! Right there! That's the exact same rock! We must be going in circles or something.
Stop looking at the rocks.
You ever notice how funny the word Grodd sounds? Grodd. Grodd.
The streets are safe once again. Next stop, crime fighting.
Level 8 sucked.
We've got you now, you...
Really not good.
Protoss. All heroes must die! Piece of junk!